Hi, and welcome to Mouse Chat. I'm Lisa, and joining me, I've got the guys. I've got Sharpie and Steve.
Hey, Lisa.
Hey.
Howdy, Lisa.
Howdy, Sharpie.
How's it going?
It's going all right. It's been a long day, but I'm kind of perky right now, doing all right.
Out of this world, are you?
I am reaching for the stars.
Oh, there you go.
Yep. It's going to be a good night. Yep. Steve, how's it going?
Good. We have some cool news. By the time the show comes out, it'll
long-awaited news.
Yeah. Well, we've talked about this before. The Star Wars Galactic Star Cruiser.
Whoop, whoop.
So they announced kind of what it is, when you can start to go, and what the adventure is.
Yeah,
and
some adventure.
Some price points. So we're going to go through.
Importantly, price points.
We have a whole website of information that we have at our fingertips here. So we wanted to kind of go over that with you. So if you're a Star Wars fan or a Disney fan, or just want to go to a very unique experience, a two-night experience, this is the show for you.
Or if you're a Disney fan who became a Star Wars fan because Star Wars became a Disney product or a Disney IP, welcome to the family. Glad you're here.
There's a lot. I'm sure there are many.
There's room in this galaxy for all of us.
Yes.
Yeah. Indeed.
So, Lisa, are you excited to board the Galactic Cruiser?
I am actually quite excited. It's coming to fruition, I suppose, and it's becoming a reality. And I'm excited. Is that stupid?
Some people say that Disney is building a Star Wars hotel. I say they're building excitement.
Okay, that's fair.
So, if you have followed our show, you know we've talked about this a couple times. If you follow Disney news, I know you've heard it. So I think, do we just want to hop right in?
Yeah,
hop right in.
Hop in about the high level.
I mean, a lot of people, believe it or not, don't have any idea what we're going to be talking about. So why don't you give them an overview of the Star Cruiser?
So the Star Cruiser is the home base of your stay. We'll talk about the theming of it all as we go. But it is a completely different two-night experience than what has ever been found at a Disney park before, or I mean, really any theme or amusement entertainment. This is kind of completely new. You and your group, so you may have from just you all the way up to a group of four, or perhaps more, depending on the room. We'll talk about that a little bit later as well. But you'll embark on a first of its kind Star Wars adventure, and you're in control. There are a lot of different options. I like to say it's kind of a choose your own adventure thing.
Yeah.
But it's the most immersive Star Wars storyline experience ever created. It is entirely bespoke. So it is completely customized. And you're going to go further into the Star Wars adventure than what anything like it has ever done. So you're going to arrive at the Walt Disney World Resort Terminal. And I am air quoting. It doesn't really work well on podcasts, but you know, I'm providing the
yes.
The verbal commentary. I'm air quoting. You're going to board a launch pod and then rendezvous with the magnificent Halcyon Star Cruiser. You're going to stay in a cabin or a suite. There are a few different room styles, and you will have a really, really amazing out of this world view, right from your own room, no matter the room type that you choose. So throughout the ship, you're going to interact with, a really different group of characters. So it's going to be a different depending on the time of day and the type of experience that you're having. You're going to sit down to really exotic cuisine again, out of this world. And perhaps you might even plot a secret mission with you and your crew. It's an option. It's out there. It's on the itinerary. Did I mention that you plan your itinerary? You're kind of in control of it. So it is up to you.
Yeah, that's kind of the, that's one of the things that's different. So based on like, it's like you were saying, like one of those choose your own adventure books where it's like, okay, now turn to page 85. So, yeah, so it's similar to that where you get to pick what you want to do. And then that kind of breaks you off into your own little sub adventures, or you can just kind of sit back and relax and watch things unfold and have a drink in your hand at the bar. And
I have a question about that drink in your hand.
Well, the drink in your hand.
Did you pay for it?
You did, unless it was the one we were talking earlier. If it's an alcoholic beverage or a specialty drink, then you did pay for it on the ship. So you do get one. Sharpie found that you do get one for free in Batu. I believe you get, if you're 21 or older, you get a free drink for the at the quick service location that they have a special little area set up for you, or you get a specialty drink for free, I believe.
But sorry to throw you off there. You led me right to it. Kind of like a horse to water.
You know, we when you come to the bridge, you got to cross it. So as you explore the different inner workings of the ship and you learn all the legends and you are taught the art of wielding a lightsaber. Yes, there are lightsaber lessons involved for those who are interested. You can even jump on a transport and head off to the planet of Batu, where your mission continues over at Galaxy's Edge. So, and I would imagine that you are definitely going to have an experience riding Rise of the Resistance without the virtual queue experience.
I would hope.
So,
I would assume.
Maybe we just found the most expensive fast pass to date.
That's definitely, I would assume that you have a special boarding group for the e-ticket attractions over on Batu.
But yeah, so like I've said multiple times, it is your own Star Wars story. Like you will have a lot of different options that you can do, which makes for a very interesting prospect of repeat visitors for this experience, which we haven't talked about price yet. So don't get too excited about being a repeat visitor until you hear all about that. But you'll have live immersive theater. You'll be part of the themed entertainment on the ship. You'll have really, really incredible dining experiences. And you will have a real life role to play in the game. So if you're not one much to get into character, maybe this isn't the experience for you. Maybe you just like to be a passive observer. But if you like to get in there, you get really caught up in the action, this experience is definitely for you.
Yes.
But you pass through an airlock. The entire world kind of shifts around you. You step into the launch pod and you launch your own Star Wars experience. So throughout that experience, you're going to have the opportunity are you going to follow the rule of the First Order? Are you going to join the Resistance? Are you going to switch in the middle? Are you going to be an undercover spy? But you can strike a bargain with a gang of smugglers or sit back and enjoy a cocktail and watch it all from a distance. Like I said, you can either be in it or you can watch it from afar. The choice is yours, totally up to you. But you going to be the hero? That's the question.
I've got to ask Sharpie, what are you going to do?
Oh, I would definitely be in the experience.
Here's some specifics on some of the things they're teasing. So one of them is wield a lightsaber as you face off against a remote training device. That sounds kind of cool. Another one is explore the bridge and operate the ship's systems and controls.
That'll be good with the kids.
That could be fun.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's see here. And then of course there's the, take the transport to Batu.
I'm going to be curious what that looks like. I hope it's not a motor.
You have the opportunity to engage in unique missions and experiences that will extend the story of your adventure. And then there's also maybe a chance to see the inner workings of the ship in the engineering room. So those are some of the things they're highlighting that sound kind of cool.
There's a lot of stuff that sounds really cool.
I mean, really, I always say things like this, and they usually come back to bite me, but Disney does stuff like this like nobody else. No other entertainment company in the world could pull this off, build a 100-room hotel on land. It's not a cruise ship experience. It's not something that happens out at sea. I mean, while everyone else is caught up in the Jeff Bezos space race, here the Disney fans are over here geeking out about going out of the galaxy and not leaving planet Earth. I mean,
yes. So should I go into a little more detail on day one, day two, day three?
Yeah.
And then we'll get into pricing. All right. So we actually have a breakdown of, because it's a set itinerary. It's similar to like going on a Disney cruise or something.
No, it's more like going to like a murder mystery dinner.
Yes.
Where it's the same.
It's the same
thing over and over.
Yes. So that's why it's mostly a set amount of, that's why it's a 2-night stay, and then it resets and everybody, you know, does it again. So that's how it's set up. So day one, you arrive at the terminal at 1 p.m. Then the launch pod to the Star Cruiser takes off between 1:15 to 1:30 p.m. Ship orientation is at 1:45 to 2:15 p.m. So you kind of get an idea. See, it's like a planned adventure where everybody's in groups probably, and they're going through these different stages. It is like a theater or a play. Light refreshments after the ship orientation from 3 to 3:30. I don't even know what this is. What's a SABACC lessons?
Come on, Steve. Sound it out.
Oh my.
What is that? SABAC? I don't even know. Is that a musical instrument? So whatever this,
I want to look at it. Hold on, I'm pulling it up.
So that is from 3:30 to 4. What is it, Sharpie? Do you know what it is?
Sabach?
Come on, Steve.
I don't even know what
use
it
your
is.
Use your context clues here.
I have no idea.
Is it initials? No, I'm curious. I don't know what that is.
It's before the muster drill.
Before the muster drill. Steve.
I'm looking
it up. Lisa's going to look it up. All right. I don't know. Next is the muster drill, which is 4 to 4:30. That's a long time for a muster drill.
Oh. Not that I know how to say it, but it's name of a popular card game with numerous variations.
It's the one that, yeah, they has the
it's like
the illuminated. You there have been pictures of it.
I saw
as
the
part
photos.
Of the part of the marketing.
Yeah, I saw the photos.
Han Solo used to play it.
Oh, that's cool.
Remember, like on the Millennium Falcon, they had that table.
Yes.
I don't know if that's where they played it.
That was more like a chess type game.
But that's where I'm picturing it.
It's similar to that, but yes. So, all right. So, muster drill 4 to 4:30. Captain's reception 4:30 to 5 p.m. Dinner featuring live music is 5:30 to 7 p.m. Outer rim regalia 7:15 to 7:30 p.m. So, that's 15 minutes. Unexpected story moment. Oh, so this is kind of an example that they put in here. So it says, for example, you might
might prove your mettle to join an elite smuggling ring.
There you go.
Or you could hide a stowaway to help the resistance.
There you go. So that's from 7:30 to 8. Oh, bridge training. That's not the card game. So that's from 8 to 8:45 p.m. And then they have special entertainment in the atrium from 8:30 to 8:45 p.m. So that's kind of a rundown of day one. So you check in at 1 and then you end at about 8:45 p.m. at night. And then day two, breakfast is from 7 to 8 a.m. There's a transport shuttle that leaves for Batu at 8:15 a.m. to 8:25. Oh, Star Wars Rise of the Resistance is 8:45 to 9:30 a.m. Then there's another special story moment, which is broker a deal for a heist or arrange to steal a ship from the First Order. So that runs from 9:30 to 9:50 a.m. Then the Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run, which is the other attraction, is from 10 to 10:30. Lunch at Docking Bay 7, Food and Cargo, which is over in Batu, that's 11:15 to 11:45. Then there's the transport shuttle back to the Star Cruiser that leaves at 12:40 p.m. till 12:50 p.m. Boy, this is like super tight. It's like they've got this down to 10 minutes.
Like, it has the ability to be like back to back. Like, if you're the type that likes to relax and just sit back and watch the world go by on vacation, I'm not sure this is for you.
So this is like, and they talk about like if you wanted to stay at a Disney World resort hotel before or after, because this is only a two night. So that's part of it too. Like, this is like an in-depth thing. So after you get back, you have lightsaber training from 1 to 1:30 p.m. Then you have droid racing competitions from 2:30 to 2:50 p.m. Build a model ship from 3 to 3:30 p.m. Sabacc tournament. So I guess you learned how to play before, from 4 to 5 p.m.
Yeah, we just don't know how to say it.
I still don't know if that's right.
And we are always very honest about this. So if you are a Disney, you're a Star Wars fan, by all means, after the show posts, message us on Facebook. Like, hey, you bunch of yokels. This is how it's pronounced.
But I do have a quick Sabacc, paragraph.
Maybe. I don't know. Sabacc. I don't know.
But I have a quick description of the game. Uh-huh. So a typical game of Sabacc is composed of several sequential rounds and officially ends when a player wins with one of three special winning hands. At the beginning of each round, each player contributes an ante to the hand pot, or the kitty, which goes to the person with the winning hand at the conclusion of that hand. So definitely a card game. That's the one where they thought Han was cheating.
Oh, that's right. Okay, so cocktails at the Sublight Lounge is from 5 to 5:30. Taste Around the Galaxy dinner, 5:30 to 7 p.m. Another story moment. Put the heist planned into action, or bring the stolen ship aboard the watch out for the first. Bring the stolen ship aboard and watch out for the First Order. 7:30 to 8:45. And then a spectacular finale is from 10 to 11 p.m.
What are you reading?
The day two.
The story moment?
Yes.
Broker a deal for a heist.
Yes.
And arrange to steal a ship from the First Order.
Ah.
I don't know if you've got a jumbled copy.
Where is this story moment?
Yeah.
At the very bottom?
Oh, that one.
Yes.
Okay. Well, it's still putting the heist plan into action. Bring the stolen ship aboard and watch out for the First Order.
There we go. I got you. All right. And then day three, breakfast from 8:30 to 9:30, and then launch pods leave the terminal at 9:30 to 10 a.m. So it's really day one starting at 1 p.m., all full day two, and then day three is breakfast, and then you're off of the ship by 9:30 a.m. till 10 a.m. So that's kind of how it runs. But like Sarpy was saying, if you're really into role playing, I mean, they have a costume and gala kind of event where you can get dressed up. I believe the costumes are provided, but I'm not 100%. It says gala apparel.
They would have I mean, robes and stuff like that, robes and hats.
Oh, well, it says.
I mean, I can only imagine the amount of merch that they're going to be.
Yeah, it says gala apparel is available in advance from Shop Disney or on the ship.
What I envision is the National Lampoon's European Vacation sequence where they are like replacing their entire wardrobe in Europe. And like, I'm envisioning people stepping out of this experience, like back into the real world. Like, what is all this?
It definitely is. Do you want to go? It's definitely interesting. Let's get to the big part that everybody's waiting for. And that's what does this cost? Lisa, do you want to do that or Sharpie? It's up to you guys.
about costs?
Sure.
All right, I can help with that.
It's broken down basically by a group of two on up, and then we only have pricing, sample pricing for the standard room.
Well, and I can go over what's in each type of cabin. So we already talked about the food and the two night stay, and your standard cabin, which is your entry level, is going to have it. It's obviously spaceship cabin like esque. Got a pull out table. It's got a TV with entertainment from your home planet. And then you have a view of outer space out the window. And this particular cabin is going to sleep 4 to 5 passengers. You get a queen bed, and then you get two berths, bunk beds. So it's not like on a cruise ship. It's definitely more like on a spaceship, where you have, they're almost like pods or cubby holes.
Mm-hmm.
So, if you do have,
is this a resort where like mom says, give me my space, and you're like, I have the space just for you.
Oh my gosh. No, sorry. No, it is not anything like that.
Come on, that joke was out of this world.
Yeah, that joke needs to go into a black hole. All right, so you've got a queen bed and then two berths, or essentially bunk beds that are really cool bunk beds. And then if you do have a fifth person, you've got a pull down.
And these actually fit adults, is what it says here for the bunk beds.
Yeah, you can fit an adult in there.
Yeah.
Even you, big guy.
I can't imagine. But
it's the same length as the queen size bed based on the illustration.
Oh, that's true. So, I guess it is.
Yeah. It's pod like. It's supposed to look small and cozy.
Yeah, it's like inset into the wall.
Yeah. So
I mean the Grand Captain suite is like
Hey.
I know.
Mr. Sharpie.
We don't even have pricing for the Grand Captain suite.
I'm just putting it out there. I'm just saying.
Okay, so at the end, we're going to talk about the standard pricing or the cabin pricing on a standard cabin. And but before that, and before Sharpie starts talking again about the other accommodations, your cabin amenities are going to have a mini fridge, hair dryer. You'll have an in-cabin safe and an interactive TV. A telephone. I don't know if it'll be called a telephone, but a communication device, if you will. And what's better than that? H2O plus bath products. If you guys...
Even in the galaxy.
Yeah.
Oh, they're not stupid. They know the good stuff, even in galaxies far, far away. So yeah, H2O, love the spa products. This is what you're going to find in the Disney resorts and Disney Cruise Line. Love it.
So, okay. So then there's only two other classes.
Aren't many.
Yeah.
And so you've got a Galaxy class suite. This is a one bedroom suite featuring a living space where everyone can gather. And then you're going to have all the comforts of what we just discussed in the standard cabin. It also has a double vanity bathroom. It has a bar area, two windows with views of none other than outer space. And then it teases that there are a few extra Star Wars surprises here. And this is the Galaxy class suite. It sleeps 4 people. And this does not have that additional pull down bed for a fifth person. So you've got your queen bed and then your two wall. Well, actually, this is different. This one's a pull down bed, one for one adult each. So all 4 beds or places in here in the Galaxy class suite are going to accommodate adults, big people. Again, you're going to have your mini fridge, hair dryer, safe, communication device, interactive TV, and your H2O. Love that. Then we get to Sharpie's Grand Captain suite. This is a 2-bedroom Grand Captain suite, which offers a lot of space for everyone to be able to move around. And it has the living space with an integrated seating area. They have all the comforts that we talked about in the standard cabin, plus a master suite with a double vanity bathroom and a second bathroom with a single vanity, and then a bar area three windows with views and some of those Star Wars extra surprises. To me, I think they simply combined the Galaxy Suite class with a standard cabin with a connecting door. So if you combine cabin number one with cabin number two, I believe that's what gets you the Grand Captain Suite. This is going to sleep eight people. Well, there goes my theory. It would have slept nine. But maybe the door connecting takes the place of that fifth bed. So I might still be right. So it sleeps eight passengers, two queen beds, and then two berths, or the bunk beds, of course, and then two wall pull-down beds. Same amenities, fridge, hairdryer, safe, communication, and TV, and then those H2O bath products. Ooh. Okay, so now we're going to go on to pricing. So this is the fun part. You guys should be trying to figure out in your head, people have been speculating for months, forever, on what the pricing is going to be. So what's good about this? I mean, it's good or bad. It depends on who you are and the structure of your party. But the more people in the room, the cheaper it gets per person. So if there are two people per cabin, you're going to be looking at $1,209 per guest per night, or $4,809 as a voyage total. $4,809 for two people for your lowest entry level category. If you have three people in the cabin, it drops to $889 per guest per night, or for the duration for three guests, it's $5,299. And we go a little cheaper per person if you have four guests in the cabin, and this is based on three adults and one child. And don't forget, an adult is considered 10 and above. So this goes to $749 per guest per night, or $59.99, $5,999 for the voyage total. So when you've got four people, you're looking at $1,500 per person. What you expected?
So my question. How much do you think the Grand Captain Suite's going to be if you fill it full with eight passengers?
Okay. I think it would be fair if this is 6,000. I will say 14,000.
Oh, I don't know. Because, all right, so then the other thing is it says on that these are sample standard cabin rates, and it says starting from, because it's based on the departure date. So,
right.
Prices are
varying.
Yeah, so if you're going a busy weekend or a holiday, and then it's based on number of guests, and then, of course, what room category you're taking. So I'm guessing that these are the starting from prices for the entry level cabins. So I'm assuming they go up from there based on things. And there's only 100 rooms on the entire ship. So it's definitely limited availability. And it's a unique experience. So that's why it's so, I mean, it was down to the 10 minutes. On some of those things that you're doing.
Up to it. So I'm saying 6,000 for four guests on the basic cabin, and I'm saying 8,000 on the one bedroom suite. And so when you combine the two, I'm going to say 14.
My logic. Your guess is 6,000, 8,000, and 14,000 for the different room types. Could be. What do you think, Sharpie?
I'm thinking it's going to be north of 20.
Oh, for the top one?
Yeah.
It could be.
Do you think
it's a two-bedroom?
Yeah, but I think it's just two connecting rooms. A classic suite. The Galaxy Class Suite and the standard cabin. I think they're just connecting.
All right. Well, the room looks... The room picture is exactly the same.
Right.
Right? If you look at the room picture in the Galaxy Class Suite and then the room picture in the Grand Suite, it's the exact same photo. The only difference is the photo above it, which is like the kids coming in and there's like a kitchenette bar area.
And that's, I think that's where like the additional living space comes in.
Yeah.
I think that's
the additional living space is different because the Galaxy Suite's got more of a sofa surrounding the edge of a couple windows looking out, and a small table, you know, and everything's done in grays. And then the ports that look out to space have those little white lights like you see on the Star Wars films. Everything, it's very well done. It looks very cool. It's just, for me, and Sharpie and I were talking about this before, me as a Star Wars fan, I don't think I have the means. I mean, like anything, you could do it if you saved and this is the thing you wanted to do, right? So you could make it happen. But it's pretty pricey. And a lot of the Star Wars fans, you know, I'm thinking like kids or whatever. It's just, I don't know how many Star Wars fans have this kind of money. Hopefully a lot. Because most comic book and science fiction fans that I know are saving to go to Comic Con and maybe a couch hopping or something. I don't know. But then again, there's a lot of people doing YouTubers and whatever that are making a ton of money, influencers, that this is a drop in the bucket to get. They could rent the whole ship. So,
jeez. Oh, I wonder if you could do that.
Well, I'm sure you could if you had the. You could do anything if you have the money.
That's true. But so, I think that would be awesome to look into.
Yeah, well, it's only awesome to look into if you have someone who wants to do it.
I want to do it.
Has the means.
We could do a pixie party.
No one's going to afford it. There's no one I know.
Sharpie will pay.
That can.
Are you going to get me the agent discount, Lisa?
Yes. Yes, absolutely.
You know, the agent discount, also known as, oh, hey, you're coming too. Yeah.
Known as, here are your H2O products. There you go.
Exactly.
That's a bonus for me.
We've included an extra special bonus for you.
Hey, by the way, this comes
with little bottles of shampoo instead of the wall pump.
That's a deal. You can take those home.
This comes with a ticket to Disney Hollywood Studios, so you can get into Batuu. Just so you know, it's included in the price. So yeah, it depends on your means and how much of a fan you are for a very unique experience. So we'll see how this does. It's if we didn't say it's spring of 2022. So it's like a year
coming
away
to a galaxy near you.
And we can book it for you. So as soon as booking starts, we are happy to get you an entry, a regular cabin all the way up to the captain's suite if you want. And then you can send us photos and videos. although I don't want to, if I saw them, I don't think I'd want to watch them because I wouldn't want to spoil it. Although I don't know if I'll ever do it.
I don't know. I mean, because we said that about a lot of things. We didn't want to watch videos of things before they actually came out.
I still haven't been on Rise of the Resistance or watched the video. I'm still waiting.
Okay.
Still waiting. Every time it comes up in my feed, I'm like, oh, scroll past.
La, 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 la.
This is all the stormtroopers standing in a row. It's got to be a Rise of the Resistance thing. That's the photo I always see. And then I'm like, oh, keep going. So what do you think, Sharpie?
Bless you.
Sorry.
Any gosh. Other input on...
I tried to reach the mute button.
No, you're fine. Any other input on the Galactic Star Cruiser?
I did more reading, and I definitely think the Grand Captain Suite is different.
Okay.
Because it has... It's two bathrooms. Two bathrooms, double wall vanity in the master suite, bar area, three windows looking out into space, and extra Star Wars surprises.
Well, that's true. The windows are different. So it's definitely a different room.
And if it was like a galaxy class suite.
Yeah.
And like a standard cabin. You would be over the booking limit.
So, Sharpie, would you suggest getting a room in the front or the middle or the back? Because you like the engine noise might be bad in the back.
I feel like a room in the back would be better because, I mean, you don't want to be you don't want to get caught up in all the space junk that you're going to be hitting as you sail through the galaxy.
That's true.
Back of the ship might be safer.
Mm, this is true. It would definitely be cool. I can imagine being immersed. I remember going to Galaxy's Edge and just walking around at night when it first opened and being in there for like 2 or 3 hours and then totally forgetting like where you were when you got out of there, and you come out and you're like, oh my God, I'm back in Orlando. So can you imagine like 2.5 days of just being immersed in it? And then all of a sudden you're back filling your car up at a Circle K and you're like, it's just like totally, it's like, you just like come out of it and you're like, what in the world? It's so drastically different because you're in this whole thing where it's all played to you and everything, everybody's in character, and it's got to be like just amazing. It's just got to blow your mind when you come back out of it. So I think that would be cool. The food looks very interesting.
So what's the one thing about this, Lisa, that really does entice you most?
Just the whole storyline, you know, being goofy and getting involved and immersed. I think that's going to be cool. I think, well, you know, the H2O products, but
I mean, that goes without saying.
Yeah, I know that's a given. But I think just the whole role playing, of course, the second day isn't as exciting just because I've been to Batuu and exhausted that a couple of times. So it's not a highlight for me. I'll certainly enjoy it, but it won't be a highlight. I think the highlight is going to be the activities on the first day on the ship and just seeing the Disney magic in play, you know, their creativity, their Imagineering, you know, to see what they do to make this a truly immersive experience. So, you know, I'll nerd out, you know, and I'm not the biggest Star Wars nerd, but I am a fan and I'm definitely a Disney nerd. So you put those two together, I guess you get a furred.
I don't know. I feel like
that's questionable, Lisa. I don't know.
It's so I don't know. I like that it's structured, but then I feel like there's no real downtime in that schedule that I was reading. Like if you wanted to hang out at the bar and talk to people for an hour or two, or wanted to play some of those games for a little while longer. I don't know. I didn't see a lot of time in there for doing things on your own, but maybe that's by design. So anyway, so that's what you definitely, if you wanted some other experience of a Disney World experience, you should book a pre or post Disney World stay. And
I think everyone will, honestly.
Yeah. I mean, it's,
you don't go down for two nights and
yeah, it's so well, that definitely adds,
it could happen too. You never know.
Well, it depends on what you want to spend on this adventure. But but that would definitely,
you know, that's a great question. What would be, Lisa, what would be your ideal pre-galactic cruiser stay and your post-galactic cruiser stay?
Pre-galactic and post-galactic?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you can do two different ones.
Okay, so my pre-galactic is going to be at Riviera.
Ooh.
Yep, one bedroom.
Good choice.
Depending on who's with me, one or two bedroom. We'll see. I'll find some friends. And my post, you're going to love this, is going to be on the Disney Wish. Thank you very much. Ooh.
I didn't even consider Disney Cruise Line as an option.
Yeah. That works for me.
Well, it does get you in the Disney Cruise Line frame of mind.
It kind of does. It's a segue.
It's got two different seating times for dinner. It has planned activities. It's that same kind of set thing. So
a little bit.
Well, very cool.
Hey, no. What? What are you guys going to do?
Oh, for pre and post? I like that.
You coming with me?
I like the pre. I mean, the only other thing, if I wanted to save some money, I might do a value at the beginning.
Sharpie's pain.
Oh, then I'm going all in. I still haven't been to the fancier, what is it?
Riviera.
I haven't been to the Riviera Resort yet. It wasn't built when the last time I was over there in that area. So I need to go there. I've been to the Grand Floridian since it reopened, and that was very nice to finally go back and see the world running again, minus the band, which I'm hopeful will join us again at some point in time. So I'm partial to the Grand Floridian. I've never stayed at the Polynesian. I've been through there a zillion times. I've eaten there.
Yeah. And it was only this past summer in 2020 that I got to stay at the
Polynesian. Yeah, you were there.
That was my first time.
With Brooke. So I don't know. There's so many places I still want to do. So many things.
Aww.
There's always something new at Disney World. So, but I love the cruise idea too. And the Disney Wish is coming out in 22, right? So Sharpie, what would you do pre and post?
My pre-stay.
Wait. This one's on Steve.
What? I'm paying.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Okay.
My pre-stay would be club level at the Contemporary.
Ah, nice.
And this is going to be really funny, but my post-stay would be Animal Kingdom Lodge. Most definitely in the President's Suite.
Wow.
Yeah. Since you're putting the bill on it, Steve.
That's Contemporary will have the new incredible rooms, right?
Correct.
Oh, that's cool. Those rooms would be fun to try. I love the Incredibles. That's perfect. Animal Kingdom Lodge, I always forget. I love that hotel. It's been so long since I've been there too. We should do an extended weekend over at Animal Kingdom Lodge just to enjoy the resort. All right, so does that wrap it up, Lisa?
I think so. I'd like to thank Pixie Vacations for sponsoring the podcast. And if you have comments or questions for us, you can send those to us at comments@mousechat.net. Thanks so much for listening. Please join us again next time on Mouse Chat.